Saint is Chilo St. John Paul School of the Saints who fell in soccer at age 15. And today we meet Saturday for us and the members of the speakers of the CCS, big mistake and Garden Saturday and hold you with me here. So all of these to bring you to continue to alter the world as we celebrate the sugars and with the celebrates. Let's start the celebration with the sign of God's love for us, the sign of the cross. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
The words that has spoken to you are spirit of life. Hallelujah. And all you know on our heart, the Lord, hear me. I will keep your commands. I call upon you, saving me, and I will do your will.
Let us pray. O God, you have indeed enlightened the world by the resurrection of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. Grant, we pray, that through his mother, the Virgin Mary, we may receive the joys of everlasting life. For our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who is the ministry of you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. The church throughout Judea, Galilee, and Samaria was at peace. She was being built up and walked in her fear of the Lord. And with the consolation of the Holy Spirit, she grew in numbers. As Peter was passing through every region, he went down to the holy ones living in Lydda. There he found a man named Aeneas, who had been confined to bed for 8 years, for he was paralyzed. Peter said to him, "Aeneas, Jesus Christ tells you, get up and make your bed." He got up at once, and all the inhabitants of Lydda and Sharon saw him, and they turned to the Lord. Now in Joppa there was a disciple named Tabitha, which translated is Dorcas. She was completely occupied with good deeds and almsgiving. Now during those days, she fell sick and died. So after washing her, they laid her out in a room upstairs. Since Lydda was near Joppa, the disciples, hearing that Peter was there, sent two men to him with the request, "Please come to us without delay." So Peter got up and went with him. When he arrived, they took him to the room upstairs, where all the widows came to him weeping and showing him the tunics and cloaks that Dorcas had made while she was with him. Peter sent them all out and knelt down and prayed. Then he turned to her body and said, "Tabitha, rise up." She opened her eyes, saw Peter, and sat up. He gave her his hand and raised her up. And when he had called the holy ones and the widows, he presented her here alive. This became known all over Judea, and many came to believe in the Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
How shall I make a return to the Lord for all the good he has done for me?
How shall I make a return to the Lord for all the good he has done for me?
How shall I make a return to the Lord for all the good he has done for me? The cup of salvation I will take up, and I will call upon the name of the Lord.
How shall I make a return to the Lord for all the good he has done for me?
My vows to the Lord I will pay in the presence of all his people. Precious in the eyes of the Lord is the death of his faithful ones.
How shall I make a return to the Lord for all the good he has done for me?
O Lord, I am your servant. I am your servant, the son of your handmaid. You have loosed my bonds. To you will I offer sacrifice of thanksgiving, and I will call upon the name of the Lord.
How shall I make a return to the Lord for all the good he has done for me?
Please rise. Alleluia, alleluia. Your words, Lord, and spirit and life. You have the word of everlasting life. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to the Scripture.
Glory to you, Lord.
Many of the disciples of Jesus who were listening said, "This saying is hard. Who can accept it?" Since Jesus knew that his disciples were wondering about this, he said to them, "Does this shock you? What if you were to see the Son of Man ascending to where he was before? It is the Spirit that gives life, while the flesh is of no avail. The words I have spoken to you are spirit and life, but there are some of you who do not believe." Jesus knew from the beginning the ones who would not believe and the one who would betray him. And he said, "For this reason I have told you that no one can come to me unless it is granted him by my Father." As a result of this, many of his disciples returned to their former way of life and no longer walked with him. Jesus then said to the 12, "Do you also want to leave?" Simon Peter answered him, "Master, to whom shall we go? You have the words of eternal life. We have come to believe and are convinced that you are the Holy One of God." The Gospel of the Lord.
Those who follow him, who will believe in him,
will be able to do this work, that much greater, not because of their power, but because of the Spirit's power in them. And so here, during these days, we journey with Jesus, we walk with Jesus, and the readings tell us how walking with Jesus means walking in the Spirit, and allowing the Spirit to work in us. The Spirit will still do what He did in the early church. The Spirit will still give us these gifts that He had given the early church, such as particularly the gift of names. But then we read the name a while ago with the introduction. The church brought all Judea, Galilee, and Samaria was at peace. Yan ang pangarap natin sa kasalukuyan. Nasa anak tayo ng simbahan ang mundo and the God that sa kapalitan. But all this only can happen when like the early, the apostles, the early Christians, we allow the Spirit to work in us. Because the Spirit reminds us of the words of Jesus for our souls to turn their life. And so today, in this Eucharist, we thank God, first of all, for the gift of the Spirit. And as we continue with this course, let us ask the Spirit to guide us, to continue to inspire us, so that we can have the dynamism, that zeal, that enthusiasm of Peter and the Apostles in preaching the Word, in evangelizing. For all this consists of what the Church today invites us to do. To be involved in the new evangelization. And the evangelization basically starting from spot, going back to how Jesus and the Apostles evangelized as they were filled with the Spirit. We ask the Spirit to fill us, to fill the Church, so that we continue to be people in the Word and nature that Jesus left us. And people then allow people to really experience that what Peter did left us in this gospel of reading today. Lord, to whom shall we go? You alone have words of eternal life. Christ gives us the words of eternal life that we believe. With that faith, we can confidently beseech our Father in heaven to hear the prayers of this community. And so we pray, Lord, hear our prayer. Bring us this Christmas sacrifice and those who become acceptable to God, the Father Almighty. As we honor the memory of the wonder of your Son, we pray, O Lord, that the oblation of the sacrifice made by your grace make of us an eternal offering to you through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift up the Lord.
As we thank the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is to be right and just our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. And to praise, bless, and glorify your name in veneration of the Blessed Virgin Mary. For by the overshadowing of the Holy Spirit, she conceived her only begotten Son, and without losing the glory of virginity, put forth in the world the eternal light, Jesus Christ our Lord. Through him the angels praise your majesty, the minions and all powers tremble before you. Heaven and the virtues of heaven, and the blessed seraphim, worship together with exaltation. May our voices be great, join with theirs in humble praise as we have prayed. The mystery of
Thank you.
resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ may be guided into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, Luis Antonio, our Bishop, and all in clergy.
Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may marry to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Empowered by the Spirit, one with the risen Lord, the God of God, our heavenly